What does this look like to you? I mean, you know what this river's like usually.
Usually it's just a normal, regular river. All this is completely insane. I mean, completely insane. And then all the houses down here on the road I live on, Tule River, they're evacuating all the houses. They're flooding. The streets all flooded, everything.
How worried are you about your place?
Oh, we live up on the hill here. I'm not worried about that.
But How are you worried about these houses?
I feel bad for these people. That guy has a deck that you can't even see. It's underwater. Well, it started raining last night, and then this morning I got up and I thought, boy, it sure is raining hard, and I opened the door and it was barely sprinkling, and it was the river making all that noise. But I just feel bad for the people living down here and stuff.
How many houses are at risk right now?
I would say probably 20.
What do you think?
It's crazy. I've never seen it like this.
Are you from here?
Yeah.
So what is, describe what this river, the Tule River, is usually like.
It's about 20 feet at the bottom, and that's about it. But yeah, this is crazy.
When did this start?
Yesterday.
And it just, did it like explode to this, or did it gradually?
Exploded, as far as I know.
I think it was,
What do you think about what you're looking at here?
It hasn't happened in a long time. And it's too bad all the nice snowpack is now going into the lake as a puddle. Because that would have been nice to have for summer water.
Describe, like, if you could point up where the snowpack was, and then it's kind of just basically gone, right?
Yeah, so we're only at about maybe 3,000 feet here, so it wasn't really thick, but we're in that cloud belt. It was pretty white from the cloud belt to the top of the mountain consistently. Mm-hmm. And we left camping 5 days ago, and there was still snow, and we came back, and here's the snow in the river.
Back-to-back really wet, cold snows, which built it up higher than I've been in previous movers.
Here?
Yeah, here. Like during the crazy drought, you just get crazy.
Mainly it's awesome because we've been in a drought for so long, it's good to have the water. Eventually it'll clear up and the lake will be nice. But like these guys who didn't move their trailer, they're gonna pay the price.
I've seen it up to the mobile homes there, but never exceeding out of 35 years. Right along the edge. I've never seen it any higher.
So this is like kind of a historic.
Historic, yeah.
Yep.
And the bridge there was washed out in 66, but they were saying about structural damage or nothing, but
it's separated.
Yeah, it's separated.
The suspension joint's growing, but that's just because of the stress.
It was, would we ever have considerable water enough for Central Valley agriculture, or would they have to fallow more and more fields? And now it's, Well, that still might happen if we only get massive bursts of precipitation in the winter, and then there isn't considerable snowpack for the summer. It's not consistent enough water for agriculture.
It's kind of sad, though, that the only way to stop one disaster is, like, another disaster.
Maybe. I feel like if we hadn't had such a warm storm on top of the beautiful thick snowpack, and then it could have melted out gradually over the spring and summer, it would have been a nicer fix.
You can see up on the mountain still a certain elevation. So actually, what you were saying, they said 8,000 feet and above, it hasn't happened that to that extent.
So I'd still be comfortable that the Upper Kern Basin snowpack is still good enough to provide us for June and in the summer months.